I was not expecting to hear that I was in danger of becoming a type 2 diabetic. That was alarming, scary, and I'm pleased that there was an outcome that I could grab hold of. If I had just been relying on my doctor saying, yeah, you better be careful, that's not enough.
Pre-diabetes, or individuals at risk of type 2 diabetes, is a clinically diagnosable condition in which one's blood glucose levels are elevated above what's considered normal, but not quite yet at the stage of type 2 diabetes levels. Individuals with pre-diabetes essentially are given a bit of a warning sign that if nothing is changed, the chances of them developing type 2 diabetes in the near future are high. When we look to the literature, diabetes prevention programs have existed, but they've been very costly and they haven't been interdisciplinary. In other words, they were focusing only on weight loss. What we saw as a really exciting potential is to develop an evidence-based intervention designed to target both diet and physical activity, but in a really sustainable manner. We talk about reducing carbohydrate consumption, reducing plain white sugars or sugar consumption in general, and increasing vegetable consumption. For physical activity, we're recommending the Canada's physical activity guidelines of 150 minutes of activity per week. The really interesting thing about what we prescribe is that it is not insurmountable.
I first came across the Small Steps for Big Changes program run by Dr. Mary Jung when I was actually working in Calgary at a clinical trials unit. What called to me about her project was that it's all about finding those meaningful changes to the participant. So in our program, they're in the driver's seat, and as a counselor, we're just there to help guide them.
We use this motivational interviewing counseling strategy, which has been demonstrated to be more effective for eliciting long-term changes.
You talk about the portions on the plate because I mentioned that.
Motivational interviewing is small changes that we can make in the way that we talk to our participants. So instead of saying, I think you worked really hard today, that's using my own judgment on how they did. And changing that around to show that they were the ones that worked hard. So using a sentence like, you worked hard today.
The instructors and the trainers made me find the right answers. I had to look within, and so within a very short time, I had to make the decision whether I was going to do this program now that I had the information or not. And that was something that the trainers and counselors were really searching for, that kind of answer from me, to look within and find out what was my motivation going to be that was going to allow me to succeed.
By partnering with the YMCA, the really unique aspect is that we're able to bring our intervention, our research, outside of the lab and outside of campus into the community.
Part of our goal in wanting to partner with Mary Jung, in particular UBC, Okanagan, is to help position our YMCA as a health-focused organization and help people understand that we want to do things the right way. We want things to be evidence-based. It just seems like such an excellent partnership because of those two realms. We've got the research realm and their expertise, and then the YMCA has their expertise in bringing programs to the community.
In my experience, the YMCA set programs that we have now are definitely good, but they are not the most up-to-date in terms of how personal they can be. The level of training is different, not absent, but just different. I think that it's very important to keep a sharp edge on what you can offer people. The old ways definitely work, but there's always that question of how could we do it better? And if we stay with the old efficacy, we stay with the people that are left behind in that old system. Being able to have these new techniques come in through something that the YMCA is supporting is that we can always get better and that we can find more people that we may be missing right now.
At this point, we're working on the pilot within the YMCA of Okanagan and training our trainers on how to run the Small Steps for Big Changes program. Right now, we have 80% of the population that isn't getting enough exercise even to maintain basic health. I think with this program, we can make a dent in that.
The more and more I worked with small sets for big changes, the more I discovered what a great program it is. It's embedded at a YMCA downtown Kelowna and is there in the community where individuals can just pop by and inquire about our program. Having that community hub is really different than, say, a clinical trial where at the end of the study, it finished and the area where those individuals were exercising is no longer available to them.
I would love to be a part of this program. Being able to advertise that we have the skills and tools, the best ones available, is something huge for me personally in my own development.
The people from Small Steps and the Y staff integrate. If you're with one group, you're with the other group. And before you know it, hi Lois, how are you doing? Good to see you. Keep coming.
We're finding really positive results with the approach that we are taking. After individuals leave our brief intervention, they're sustaining their physical activity behaviors up to a year. The weight that they lose, they're maintaining that weight loss again for up to a year. And in fact, our results show that they're actually getting fitter after 1 year being outside of our program.